Friday bread line in Castlecomer. These men are miners. Now there are no mines.
I fear that the day that our redundancy payments will run out, and I have only 2 more weeks to go now. After that, we don't know what to do. I will only have £3.05. £3.05 a week to live on, £3.15 from January next. But come January, my dole money will be gone out, and there'll be nothing there for me but free dole. I don't know what that amounts to, but free dole, because quite possibly I'd have committed suicide by then. I fear that so much now. My mind is off everything. I have no will to live or do anything.
Deer Park Mine, 2 miles from the town. When it closed on January 31 of this year, the miners lost more than a job, they lost a way of life. Once 10,000 people fed from this and the other pits in the area. In the 20s, it was reckoned 180 million tons of coal could be mined around here. Dreams, perhaps. They're dead now, like Deer Park. Silent and derelict, it will never again be mined. The pit is flooded, the shafts sealed. This pit was worked for 45 years. The day it closed, 300 years of mining ended in Castlecomer. The closure was inevitable. For 4 years, losses were nearly £2,000 a week. The government propped it up with more than £250,000 in aid when its owners threatened to close it in 1965. But it was money for wages rather than investment. Deer Park, like a wounded giant, died finally in January when the government refused further money. An obsolete mine had no future. The miners, 183 of them, only a quarter of the workforce of other years, got 1 week's notice after a lifetime in the mines. This pit has been closed for 8 months. Today, 77% of the miners, that's 142 men, are still out of work.
I've been a miner all my life, 46 years, and developed an industrial disease, pneumoconiosis. And we're in a bad way now. We've 5 of our lads in a bad way. They didn't qualify for redundancy money. And when all our redundancy money is up, we're in a bad way. We'll only be on social service.
Can you work?
Oh, no. Can't work. You wouldn't be employed nowhere. You couldn't work on it because you have no wind, you know. It's colder than the lungs. You can see, I can't really have... What's better to talk to you?
Have you tried to get a job anywhere?
Oh, no. I wouldn't be able to work. Just walk around slowly, that's all. Take my time.
What was it like in the mines?
Well, we were brought up in that atmosphere, and I started a shilling a day. We were brought up in that atmosphere, and that's the only thing we knew. We thought we were men when we went down, you know. Brought home the first shilling. We enjoyed it while we were in.
Did you ever think the mines would close?
Yes, I had an idea. Because the youth are not inclined to go down. And they're bloody well right. It's not a life for no one. It's only a dog's life.
I miss the mines very much because I have 7 children going to school still. The dole money is small. It's only £9 a week. There's no chance of a job. There's no one seem to be doing anything about getting his jobs around here.
Wouldn't have a hope of getting a job now. There's too many looking for work around, young fellas. There's a hope for you or me, is there?
No, I wouldn't think so.
No, there wouldn't be a hope.
There is lots of jobs. Outsiders is getting them. They're coming in from Dublin and Ballaragget and Carlow into these, and they're not getting workers off an exchange here. So I don't think it's fair.
I fear the thought of what's going to happen to me. I don't know. I have no use in looking for employment anywhere. Well, they're training a few places, and any big firm now, they usually send you for x-ray. And you two, minors disease, you work on meconiosis, I have no supply anywhere. I thought at the onset, when the mine was finished, that at least the company would send us jointly, people of my age and service at least, for mass x-ray to determine what proportion of pneumoconiosis we had. Because we will have no compensation unless you are, I believe, 100% in this country.
The miners' union has been concerned more with redundancy money than retraining.
Nothing has been done generally, only that we were all hoping, you see, in the local branch that the new industries would absorb at least 50% of the older men. But so far we've been very disappointed at the number of the older men that haven't been getting jobs. In my opinion, that many of the young men, the younger men, were waiting for to get employment in the new factories, the new industries. And the older men, I think, they said to themselves, well, at my age, I haven't any use to be trained for a new job.
Two-thirds of the miners are between 40 and 60 years old. So far, only 9 are employed in the one new factory in production. 3 other factories are planned in an area classed as underdeveloped. The IDA optimistically estimates employment at 278 men. How many of these jobs will go to the miners? Years in the pits affect their adaptability.
One thing that is extremely important in our industry, in the textile industry, is manual dexterity. In the sense that one has to have a certain level of suppleness in the fingers. And quite naturally, a miner who has spent upwards of 15 to 20 years actually at the coal face, this becomes somewhat of a problem. We've had to take this into consideration in selecting labour here. So, in the case of our local miners, there isn't necessarily an age limit. I'd much rather put it by saying that the limit depends on the amount of actual manual dexterity.
Castlecomer is only now being affected by the closure of the mines. Redundancy payments kept incomes to 90% of the £2,300 a week earned from the pit. In fact, factory construction meant more money than ever in circulation. It's different now. Miners' earnings have dropped from £20 a week to an unemployment handout of around 7. The urge to work, missing in the early days of redundancy, has returned, but there are not enough jobs. So far, 71 families, around 321 children, are affected. A big proportion of a town of only 1,200 population in an area of 5,000 people. And the worst is yet to come.
If you have an industry working for something like 50 years, indeed it's been called here, produced here for 300 years, I mean, you just can't see the bad day. And we didn't see it. I'd admit it now years ago. But when the mine closed, I mean, we knew we were up, our backs were to the wall, and we got about doing something about it.
Would you think that with redundancy payments still persisting that you're living in a fool's paradise?
It occurred to me, but on the other hand, we have 4 factories. Actually, 1 in production and the rest just beginning to. They'll be taking on men within the next, one of them within a month. And I would suggest that you're just about a month too soon.
When a mine dies, and a way of life with it, what's to be done? No attempt has been made to retrain the miners. Indeed, in some cases, it is too late for retraining. In Britain, there is a scheme for supplementary benefits for older miners made redundant by pit closures. A call has been made for such a scheme here. Something must be done. There is no place in Castlecomer now for the skills of men bred on a tradition 300 years old. There can be no place either for the once a week queue of despair.